Assalamualaikum everyone and welcome to today's Bitcoin update for Wednesday, 10th of August. And we're looking at Bitcoin right now. And I just noticed that one thing that Bitcoin really did, and yesterday I just mentioned this one on the Discord, that, you know, I just reanalyzed Bitcoin again and there's a range trap. And Bitcoin never broke out of anything. Keep an eye on tomorrow's update. So what I really want to say is that previously we did make a trend line here. And as far as I actually noticed that trend line, it seems like Bitcoin did not really break out. So we're going to actually analyze what the hell is going on. What are we about to do? Is this still a chance for Bitcoin to move higher? Or is it finally time for the three black crows on a monthly time frame to really play out and we see Bitcoin literally dropping to the downside? That's something that we want to see, right? So I'm on the daily time frame right now, and yesterday, you know, this almost was like this. So I'm going to show you what a range trap really is. So if you do bring this like that, that almost looked like a breakout, didn't it? Okay, it looked like a breakout. But you know, the data that I'm actually using right now is taking us from 22 March, okay, all the way down here to the August. So we're talking about 5 months apart nearly. And when you take 5 months of data in between, it actually becomes a little bit difficult for you to kind of get all the support touches coming to make sense. But I think this is pretty much complete as for now, okay? And the previous one that I draw like down a little bit here, which made 11 August being the decision time, actually is now extending to 14th of August. And we never broke out of anything. We're still in there. So I'm going to show you the second range trap that they can do again, because I'm just going to do this one with you. So let's zoom in on Bitcoin right there. So Bitcoin had, it started right over here by 26th of March. So you had that touch there. This one touch here, and then you had the touch right there where you actually lost that trend line. And as soon as you lost the trend line, what did you do? You end up just, you know, flipping to the downside here, went up a little bit, came up, and you find that support as resistance there. You find a resistance number two then, and then you kept on losing it, and then you went to the downside, came up again, and boom, this is where you actually have met that line once again, all right? At the current situation though, there's support coming in, and this support shows this touch here. You have support there, you have another support right there, and you're finally having another support right here. You haven't now broken to the downside just yet. You haven't really done that, and you haven't even really broke out to the upside. But there's a range trap number two, and the range trap number two is gonna be this line right over here. So if you actually go back up to that line, this second trend line here, that can be another range trap, and you can see this thing actually still moving to the downside after hitting 24,442 or something, and then boom, go to the downside. But I don't think that's gonna happen. The chances are really are that you really break that one as well, if you're gonna break the first resistance line right over there. So if I do now go back up here, I want to remove all those drawings that I just did for a second there, and let's go back to a cleaner chart. I'm just going to remove the second range at the moment. Let's focus on this one. If I turn on the line graph, you can see how the line are perfectly touching one another at the moment. That's a very, very perfect touch right there, okay? If I do bring the, you know, where's this one? I don't know if it's high low. Yeah, if you do see at the high lows as well, the candlestick here, you can see how the touches are. So a touch here, the touch there, the touch here, break to the downside, came up, rejected there, rejected here again, came down, rejected nearly there, and rejected nearly here once again. And likewise, similarly, you do have the support coming in there, coming in here, coming in right there. So very, very soon again, we still are in a suspense. We never really had our suspense been answered. There are still chances that you really are gonna break to the upside. Yes, there are still chances for that one to happen. Just because Bitcoin has come down, this could just be a correction to the downside and you still have chances to move higher. But the weekly time frame now has a doji, And this weekly time frame and how the weekly really closes will tell us everything, okay? The last time that you had a doji on a weekly time frame after moving up, you see, you went down like this, you try to go up, right? You made those green candles, and then you finally made that doji right there. So if I do bring this one here, you made the doji, you made the red candle, you actually printed out an evening star. The same thing is gonna happen if I do zoom in here, and right now all you have is a doji right there, some sort of a shooting star, whatever. That's the doji, that's a decisive candle. And as far as I see things, yes, you actually broke out of it, but the problem is that was a wick, and we don't really like the wicks. You have 4 days to close the weekend. How you close the weekend is going to determine. If it ends up green like this, amazing. If it ends up closing red like this, then be ready for something really worse in the future. Because the last time that you did make that doji up here, the last time you made the doji, look at how badly you went to the downside. And that same can be said after this doji has been made, you try to fall down once again. And the biggest hint that you're going to fall down can be BNB itself. So if I show you BNB, look at the, I'm going to show you this one, right? So we're talking about a rising wedge on BNB at the moment, okay? And this rising wedge can take BNB all the way down to this price level of nearly $242. You've been actually overextended, made a rising wedge, and you actually push into the downside, right? So that's the doji you made, and this is on a daily time frame, and you're looking to actually move to the downside from this area, okay? That's the biggest hint. And you know, if BNB is gonna come down, then it doesn't come down by itself. That means that Bitcoin has to be coming down, because BNB really mirrors Bitcoin. Especially not this time, it has been moving on itself. But when it dumps, that actually just shows that Bitcoin is willing to do something really, really bad as well. Normally, when BNB dumps, you might be looking at Bitcoin to actually dump to the downside as well. So you still haven't really broken out of anything, at least for now on the daily time frame. You're holding all this support line. And as long as you're holding support, keep the coin, it's fine. It's amazing. It's just that it's inside a decision pattern that is coming in by 14th of August, which is an Independence Day in our country, by the way. So is it going to be independent? Are they going to actually make Bitcoin independent by 14th of August, or are they going to make Bitcoin without any independence on 14th of August? We're going to see that. We're going to see how true the independence is going to be. We're going to see how the freedom is really going to be. And it pretty much sums up for this current update at the moment. Let's see what really happens. I do think 14 is final. I don't see any other range trap at the moment except for the second one that I just showed you up there. Whatever happens, we're going to see next in the future about the coin itself. And that's it for today's update. I'm going to see you in the next one. Allah Hafiz.